Hi guys, my soapbox Sunday. I excuse my bags under my eyes. I am tired. I feel like I'm gonna die. We had all these events this weekend, plus like me working 20 hours a day on top of a super, super long week that I've kept you guys posted on. So don't act like you don't know what I'm talking about. But I wanted to do a quick little, you know, my soapbox thingy because I promised I would do it. Hi, Teresa. Kisses, I miss you. Anyways, a quick little thing here because I think it's really cool. I'd like to share it with you guys. So I got a super amazing Christmas present from my best friends in the whole world. Two of my best friends in the whole world, me and John, is Harshal and Carla. They are the most amazing people I've ever met in my entire life, and they're just amazing. I mean, they're amazing. So anyways, long story short, I was given this present, and the reason I'm showing it to you guys is because, God forbid, I was to like actually buy myself something nice and then post it on Facebook, it'd be like the whole end of the damn world, right? But these are called Valentinos. Valentinos, okay? I'll be totally honest with you. Until about a year ago, I didn't know what the hell a Valentino was. In fact, I was, and I am going to tag you in this, Carla, so you can laugh at me, but I went shopping for Carla last Christmas, and I asked Harshal, I'm like, so what is she like? You know, I don't know what to get her. And he listed off all these, like, fancy-ass names, and I'm like, oh, okay. I'm like, I've heard of Gucci and maybe some of those other names, but like they started listing off all these names and I'm like, I have no idea what you guys are talking about right now. So anyways, I don't come from like a super rich family. I mean, me and my brother, and you know, we grew up like my parents literally, and I love you, Mom. And if you watch this, I apologize. I'm telling the whole world about your, you know, salary range when I was growing up, but it's the truth and people like the truth. I guess that's just what it is. What up, Doug? Hi, Jay. What's up, people? Hey, John. So, yeah, I didn't grow up with money. They live paycheck to paycheck. I mean, I lived in Florida my whole life. And the first time I went to Disney was when I met John at 21 years old. So, gotta tell you a little something. So Valentino was very foreign to me. Okay. So was Gucci and anything else. We just didn't have the money. So, you know, it's important that I share that with you guys because, you know, no matter how successful you are in life, you need to remember your roots and where you come from. And even if you come from money, because think about it. I mean, John, his family comes from money. Like they were entrepreneurs. They made a great living. And somehow by some crazy way, I don't know how John ended up like that, but he still ended up like super, super humble. I don't know how he ended up so humble, but he really did. He ended up humble. Hi, brother. I was just talking about how we grew up like, you know, parents like paycheck to paycheck and how we didn't have money. And now that, you know, I have a pair of my very first Valentinos, and no, I didn't buy it myself because if I did, that'd be the end of the world. And I just couldn't share it with you guys because then it would be like horrible. But anyways, so she bought me these shoes and I'm super excited to try them on and see, you know, how they fit and everything. But, you know, in the bigger scheme of things, as I open these, you know, to me, it's honest to God, money means nothing unless I have a really good relationship with my husband, unless I have my health, and unless I have, you know, happiness. I mean, what's money if you're not happy, you know? It doesn't mean anything at that point. You got to agree with me on that, right? So, you know, it's important that you're happy no matter how much money you got or how much money you don't have. I'd rather be happy than, you know, I mean, money does make things easier. Don't get me wrong by any means. But it's important that you remember where you come from and you stay grounded. Hello. I'm on live. Do you want to come say hi? Sure you do. So anyways, Peter just walked in. I instill these things into Peter as well. So that way he understands that it's not everything is about money. And, you know, it's important to know the value of a dollar. I mean, come on. I mean, my dad told me, he's like, I'm going to get you.
That's a lot of money.
I'm going to get you what you need, and you'll get you what you want. So, when I wanted my very first pair of Nikes, I went, got a job, and I got my own pair of Nikes because they weren't going to be bought for me. So, that's just what it is. But that's Mamie, the person I am today, you know? Say hi.
Hi. This is my meme today.
Okay, go sit over there for a second. No. Peter has chores to do tonight, so I'm going to make this quick and simple. But anyways, I wanted to show you these because I think they're super cute. And I'm so excited to wear them. And I'm like super, super happy for my very first Valentinos. I know, I sound like such a like a little kid like in a candy shop. Like, oh my God, I got my very first Valentinos. Look at me. Little did I know is, you know, a year ago, I didn't even know what the hell Valentino meant. And I still don't know half of these names. And to be quite honest with you, I'll be totally real with you. Cool, I got a pair of Valentinos. But if you left it up to me, right, and it's my money, let's just say that I was given, I'm going to throw a number out there. Let's say I was given $300, right? Would I rather go to the store and get one thing for $300? Or would I rather go to the store and get 50 things for $300? So I could, I'd be more than happy to go to wherever, whether it's a Gucci, Windsor, you know, or Charlotte Russe. You got these $5 tops and these $11 pants and these $20 dresses. I'll put it on, I'll rock it. And I'll rock it like as if it was a $500 dress, but it wasn't. So anyways, I like, I like quantity over quality when it comes to that kind of stuff. So anyways, I figured I'd share that information with you. A lot of people don't know much about me or my upbringing or, you know, where I come from. And, you know, like I said, John comes from a very, very wealthy background, and I don't know how he stayed so humble. I would love to find out from his parents how they kept him so grounded and so humble and make him like the nicest guy he is today. Me, on the other hand, I mean, I didn't come from very much money, and my parents did whatever they could. My dad worked 3 jobs, and my mom came home after her 9-to-5 and would cook dinner, get us in the shower, get us to sleep, do what we need to do. I mean, you know, the struggle was real. I mean, literally, the struggle was real. So, I mean, I'm blessed to have what I have. Granted, I bitch and complain about, you know, not getting enough sleep, which is probably partially my fault. But you know, it is what it is. I'd rather, you know, be on a lack of sleep and, you know, be extremely exhausted and have a successful career and, be busy all the time than the opposite, you know, and sleep in bed and do nothing and be totally worthless. Okay. So, I mean, there's some happy mediums, I'm sure, in there somewhere. I just haven't quite found that out yet. Anyways, I've got literally, so let's see, it's 7:33. I've got probably about 48 text messages that I have to address, and I have 102 emails I have to address. I still haven't checked the Facebook account to check all the messages, and I haven't checked the Instagram account to check all the messages. So I better get to work. And then Peter is going to be ever so kind enough. He actually lost a bet the other day.
Yeah, maybe.
No.
You have to back up like 5 feet just to cheat up there.
Listen. Only bet on a sure thing, okay? Make sure you understand that. And I taught my son that the other night. Be quiet. I taught my son that the other night. He tried to throw in my face that he ate my last popcorn. Little does he know is that the last time he ate my last popcorn, because that's the only snack that I like to eat.
That at least has fiber in it.
Anyways, the only snack that I like to eat, he eats the last one, leaves the empty box in the freaking closet, and I'm pissed because I go in there thinking there's freaking popcorn, and there's not. So he tells me the other night, hey, Mom, I ate your last popcorn. And I'm like, oh, you did? Little does he know, I ordered 5 boxes of popcorn, I don't know, a couple months back. And because I know that Peter is very bad about eating the last thing and not sharing it with Mommy until I find out that it's really gone, I took a very special box of popcorn and stuck it up in the very top of the closet, right? So then I went over to him and I was like, are you really sure about that? Are you sure that you ate the last popcorn? And he says, yeah, Mom, I ate the last popcorn. I'm like, okay. I'm like, so what if I bet you didn't? And he goes, oh, well, yeah, no. So we walk over to the closet. I close the door with my hand. And I said to him, I said, I'll tell you what. If there's a popcorn in this closet right now, okay, you're going to wash my laundry on Sunday. You're going to wash it. You're going to dry it. You're going to fold it. And then you're going to give it to me and I'll pack it away. And Peter's never done laundry. So he'll do it under my supervision. He has never done laundry by himself. And he does not know how to do laundry, nor has he ever folded his own clothes. So he's going to learn how to fold tonight.
I folded my clothes.
Anyways, but I said, if there happens to be no popcorn in here whatsoever, I'll give you $100 cash now on the spot. Right now. Deal, Mom. Deal. Deal. Okay. So we open the closet. I know what I'm getting into. I told him he better not bet on anything, especially when somebody's that, like, solid about, oh, there's something in the closet when there really isn't. So I open the door, and he's like, see? And he looks on, like, the third shelf, and he's like, see, it's not there. I told you. I told you. And I was like, really? So then I went up, and I grabbed the box from all the way at the top where he can't see it because he's a baby midget. And so I grab it, and I give it to him.
You, girl.
I give it to him. And I show him that there was a box of popcorn up there. So he lost the bet. Bigger scheme of things here. And the moral to the story is don't gamble. Okay? Only bet on a sure thing. His dad says that all the time. John says, I only bet on a sure thing. I don't gamble. You know, so if I told him, I was like, listen, if you're not 100% sure, don't make the bet. Especially when somebody is like, you know what? You sure about that? You real sure? So he did learn a lesson that night, and I don't think he's ever going to make another bet, ever. Anyways, I'm super exhausted, and I have a lot of work to do, and apparently so does Peter, because I still have a whole entire load of laundry to go. So anyways, I wanted to share my Valentino story with you guys. I love, love, love my new shoes. I can't wait to wear them, and I'm really excited. I've not used to, like, having, like, amazing friends that, you know, like, are able to get me gifts like this. This is crazy. I mean, I love you guys, but this is crazy. Okay. And you know, the people I have been friends with, most of those people I've been friends with for about 15 or 20 years. And, you know, I get it. It's important that you have real good friends in your life and you're able to keep those relationships for a long time. So, I did get him, James. I got him. But I taught him a lesson. I did teach him a lesson, right? He doesn't want to admit it. He doesn't want to admit
it. At least
he's admitting
he
admit it.
I get over.
Listen, I told him, I made him a deal because I'm a cool mom like that, is that if he washed a second load of laundry, a.k.a. that. Okay, if he washed a second load of laundry, that I would give him money. See, I mean, I'm that nice mom
of
me.
Isn't that nice?
He's got to go. I mean, listen, I told you guys about our Sunday routine. He needs to go around the house and replace all the air fresheners. I'm sure I can find some other things he needs to do. So anyways, I've got things that I have to do, and I'm going to let you guys all have a wonderful Sunday. I need to get some rest, or I'm going to be very, very cranky tomorrow. And I need to sleep the entire week just to make sure I have enough energy for our Gasparilla float on Saturday. Can't wait. I'm so excited.
Oh my God. No,
all right, guys. I'll talk to you soon. Everybody have a great night. I'm out.
Now.